Hey, what up, guys? JT Adventures here, and Big T here. I don't know if you guys have seen my really old video on the Spyderco Tenacious, but I made that video back like the very first day that I got it, and now I've had this for a couple years now, and now I can give you a full report on the knife. So this will be an update video slash re-review kind of a video. So let's get right into it. So let's talk about how the blade has held up. I'm going to be using this cardboard as my up-close aid. So here's the blade. No chips or anything. The blade's exact same condition as if it came out of the box. And I've been carrying this to get more like acquainted with it again and to test it a little bit more, and I've been carrying this at work for the past 2 months every day. So the integrity of the blade is perfectly fine. It's still razor sharp and easy to get an edge on. This is 8CR 13 MOV stainless steel, and then it has the little Spyderco symbol right there, and then the hole to get the knife open, and the action is still nice and easy. In my previous video, I just barely got it, so I couldn't even flick it open yet. That's how early I made the video. So now it flicks. I can flick it right open. And you can even, if I can get this on the first try, I put my finger in here and grab it with my thumb. And then you can flick it open too without even using the hole. So yeah, so it's easy to open. And then the jimping on this is very nice, and it's like a perfect roughness. It really locks in your thumb right there. It's not too sharp or too smooth. It's like just right. And then it has this like small ramp, so it just helps prevent your finger from going up. But there's no jimping on that. There's just jimping on the liner lock. And then G10 handles, and those have held up great too. G10 is just a great handle material. It's very tough and water resistant, and like resistant to all kind of climates and stuff like that. So it's just a great all-around steel. It only works for right-handed, like for your right hand to close the lock. And then it locks up good. And this is like one of the rare, like this is pretty much the only knife I have that has like no side-to-side play and no up and down. So after all the years of opening and close it, and sometimes I'll just sit there and flick it open and close it and flick it open. And that has to do, it has like a brass, if you can see in there, has like a brass little washer type thing, and that keeps it nice and tight and smooth opening. And this is just a great high-valued knife. I'll probably annotate the price on this, but it's a very high-value knife. If you want a Spyderco knife and you don't want to pay a lot, then this is the knife for you. And then another great thing is this is adjustable for everywhere. It's adjustable, so it starts out here, which is a tip down right pocket carry, and also goes tip up, which I need to switch because I like tip up more, and then left-handed tip up and tip down, which is great because it has so many different choices if you want a particular carrying style. And then you can tighten it with just a little Allen key, and then you can take these off with an Allen key too. nice and centered in there. And then it has stainless steel liners, which are hollowed out. You can get inside there, so you can see that. And you can see all like the pocket lint and crap in there. So it's hollowed out on top and bottom to reduce weight. And then, speaking of weight, I got my trusty scale here. And we'll check out how much it weighs. So 4 ounces, which is pretty standard, pretty good weight. And the size of this thing, it's from the very beginning of the handle, very beginning of the blade, is a little over 3 1/4 inches. And then this blade comes all the way back. So if you want to get some like fine, really fine carving, you can get up on there and really dig in there and carve really fine stuff. And then the overall, from the very bottom to the very tip, is about 7 3/4 inches. And then closed is a little over, it's a teeny bit over 4 1/4, so that equals 7 3/4. That's it closed. The only thing I have about this, the only ding about this, is the pocket clip. I like the modularity of changing it. And if you changed it, well, if you look at it, it really rides high in the pocket, so that much is going to be showing, that much and up. But if you switched it over here, then probably that much would be showing, and it's a lot less. Like, it's just a little bit compared to this whole chunk right here, compared to this little chunk. So that's one thing I don't like about it. I don't really like the pocket clip as in its carrying position. The pocket clip itself is good. It holds it in there tight. I wish this was a little bit more angled up. So if you have, like, a thicker pocket and you're trying to get this in, I know I have one pair of shorts that I can't, I have to like really fish this on to get onto there. But once it's on, it's staying on there. And then it has the Spyderco symbol right there on the clip too. I don't know if you can see, but on this bottom part, I scratched it up a little bit from when I was laying down trying to change oil. So that's the knife. It's made in China, if you didn't know that already. If you can see it. Oh, there it is. Behind that gunk. So it's made in China. All around really great knife, really rugged. After all the years, I've not had to adjust the tension on this or anything, and it just keeps on ticking no matter what. I think I've batoned with this a little bit, so I just bend it a little and then baton with it, and it holds up fine. And it's a flat grind, which is a great grind. The only thing about this is it's kind of plain looking. The blade shape is kind of good, but it doesn't have much of a belly. And it's kind of just like an kind of a knife. To me, there's nothing really special about it. And then it's really wide. Let me get my tape measure again. So it's a little over 1.5 inches wide, which is pretty wide for a pocket knife. Like, I have no other knives that is this wide. So it takes up quite a bit of real estate in your pocket. And I guess it's a little thin. It was kind of bulky. Get the ruler again. So about, with the pocket clip, it's about 1/2 inch wide. So I don't really, never really measured any of my other knives to see how wide they are, but it's pretty standard width. But this way, it's really wide. So it's a good knife. It will get every job done that you need. But it's kind of just like an eh. Nothing real special about it. Great price point. Decent stainless steel. It sharpens really well and it holds its edge for a medium length of time. Has a lanyard hole, and then you can disassemble it with Allen wrenches too. So that's all I have to say about it. It's a little update. I've been carrying it for a couple years now. As I said before, all that stuff, like just really good standard liner lock knife, pocket knife. So that's my little update and updated review on the Spyderco Tenacious. Thanks for tuning in, guys. Don't forget to rate and comment and subscribe to JTadventures. Thanks, guys. So let's see if I can do it again. I'll hit the table. Heck.